says he respects her decision. We mentioned Ossoff was in Jefferson County today, and he was there to talk to county leaders about a new grant program that will make access to high-speed internet easier in rural Georgia. News Channel 6's Hannah Lettier has more on the impact.
Senator Ossoff secured $250 million through the American Rescue Plan to bring high-speed internet to rural counties across Georgia.
He says families, small businesses, farms, and schools will benefit from it. The Georgia Office of Planning and Budget is supposed to distribute the funds soon. Ossoff also says more funds are on the way because of the bipartisan infrastructure law.
There are about 1 million Georgians who don't have broadband internet access. This is a historic day in the economic history of the CSRA. Major investments are on their way to help connect homes and businesses in Jefferson County and across the region with high-speed internet access.
Ossoff says it'll be sometime next year before the project is put into motion, but he's dedicated to ensuring all Georgia communities have affordable, high-speed broadband. In Jefferson County, Hannah Lettier, WJBF News Channel 6.
Alec Murdaugh is back in court today. His attorneys are talking about Murdaugh's murder trial, which is slated to start in January. They're discussing several motions from both sides, including what evidence will be allowed in the murder trial, as well as whether Murdaugh will be shackled during the trial. That hearing is in its third hour right now. A well-known environmental advocate speaking in Augusta about the toxic... They don't feel like a Christmas parade on it tomorrow. All right, thanks, Tim. It was the opposite of a learn-from-home day in Richmond County schools. The school system's e-school students were back in the classroom today for STEAM Challenge Day. That gave them an opportunity to take part in hands-on science experiments, participate in engineering challenges, and work together to solve problems.
They do a lot of tutoring online through different organizations, and it's all, they feel like it's robotic. So when they come here, it just gives them a chance to get out of the house and then just, you know, fellowship with their fellow students and their teachers.
Most e-learning students don't communicate with teachers often, so organizers say it's a good chance to get feedback from those teachers. She's an employee who is truly selfless and is paying off for her. Coming up, how she's being rewarded for her hard work when News Channel 6 at 4 continues.
Foundation Repair. We'll remove all the drama of keeping your home healthy.
A big reward for a woman inspired to become a caregiver during the pandemic. Her name is Christy White, and she's a single mom with no vehicle. She joined Cornerstone Caregiving in Lubbock, Texas 2 years ago. Thursday, White was chosen as a National Caregiver of the Year out of 75 candidates from across the country, and she was given a new car by the company. What a nice thing for her. It's like Santa came early.
Yes.
And there is more coverage you can count on coming up next at 4:30 with Sean Cabbage Talk.
Hi, Jenny. Thank you. And coming up at 4:30.